Hey everyone, Intel's latest 14th generation Raptor Lake Refresh processors are launching real soon, and motherboard manufacturers have refreshed their lineup of Intel LGA 1700 motherboard offerings in anticipation for this launch. With that in mind, for today's video, we'll be taking a look at a new Intel Z790 motherboard offering from ASUS, the TUF Gaming Z790 PRO-WIFI. Let's get started. Now, the TUF Gaming Z790 PRO-WIFI that we have here today, as its name implies, sports the not-so-new Intel Z790 chipset, which was originally launched alongside Intel's 13th generation Raptor Lake processors back in September 2022. Being from the TUF Gaming series of motherboard offerings targeted at gamers on a budget, where it places below the ROG Maximus and ROG Strix series of boards, and above the value-oriented Prime series of motherboard offerings by ASUS, the TUF Gaming Z790 PRO-WIFI is targeted at consumers looking for a more budget-friendly Intel Z790 motherboard offering. In keeping with the design language of the TUF Gaming series of products, the Z790 PRO-WIFI comes in a box sporting a silver-on-black color scheme, with touches of yellow thrown in for contrast. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. With that, the board comes with a Wi-Fi Q antenna, which comes with connectors that snap into place for ease of setup. Now let's set aside the board for now to see what other accessories ASUS has included with it. First up, we get two SATA 3 cables, and these are accompanied by a M.2 drive screw and standoff pack. We do also get two packs of M.2 drive rubber pads that add additional height clearance for single-sided M.2 drives. Moving on, we also get a quick start guide right here, and surprisingly, a DVD driver disc, even though optical drives are becoming a thing of the past. On top of these, we get a certificate of reliability that shows the battery of tests that some of the components of this board have been subjected to, a sheet of TUF Gaming stickers, as well as an ASUS web storage promotional offer leaflet. Onto the board itself, we see that ASUS has gone for a black and grey colour scheme with touches of yellow, which is very much in line with the TUF Gaming brand identity. The board comes with an integrated I/O shield design, where ASUS has liberally embellished the I/O shroud with a bunch of gamer catchphrases. Now, it's interesting to note that this section here is a raised rubber insert. I suppose it does add some aesthetic interest to the board. Moving on, we get large black heat sinks with TUF Gaming motifs all around to spruce up the overall appearance of the board. In terms of onboard RGB LEDs, the TUF Gaming Z790 PRO-WIFI has an illuminated TUF logo in this corner of the board, which, all things considered, is pretty subtle in terms of its appearance. The VRM heatsinks for this board are pretty decently sized, and ASUS has included 16+1+1 power stages that are rated for up to 60 amps. As can be seen, the board comes with a passive heatsink for the Z790 chipset, which is adorned with the TUF Gaming logo. For M.2 drive cooling, ASUS has included M.2 drive heatsinks for 3 out of the 4 M.2 drive slots that this board comes with. Over on the rear of the board, we get some subtle TUF Gaming motifs, which are a nice touch, I suppose, in spite of the fact that most of these motifs would likely never see the light of day inside of a PC case. For memory support, the TUF Gaming Z790 PRO-WIFI comes with 4 DDR5 slots, with support for up to 192GB of RAM and the DDR5 7800+ standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a single tab design that ASUS calls QDIM. Near the RAM slots is a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C front panel header that supports the power delivery 3.0 standard with fast charging capabilities of up to 30 watts. And beneath it, a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header that supports up to 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. While still on the topic of front panel USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses two USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for up to two USB 2.0 Type-A ports. Onto some of the special features that this board comes with, we get a serial port header located right here, which is a legacy feature that could come in useful, especially in more business-oriented settings. We do also get a Thunderbolt 4 header that is to be used in conjunction with a Thunderbolt 4 add-on card that is sold separately by ASUS. Moving back up top, we get QLEDs, which are built-in LEDs right here that can be used to troubleshoot power-on self-test issues. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 5.0 x16 slot for a graphics card. The SID slot comes with the safe slot feature that reinforces the slot for use with heavy graphics cards, and also has what ASUS calls Q-Release. Now, Q-Release is a feature that makes removing a graphics card a painless affair, especially from a completed build. Pressing this button here will undo the Q-Release latch to allow the graphics card to be pulled out from the slot with ease. Moving on, we also do get a full-length PCIe 3.0 x16 slot that operates at X1 mode, a PCIe 4.0 X4 slot, a PCIe 3.0 X1 slot, and a full-length PCIe 4.0 x16 slot that operates at X4 mode. In the storage department, ASUS has included 4 SATA 3 ports, of which 2 of them are in a right-angled configuration and 2 of them in a straight-angled configuration. For M.2 slots, it comes with 4 PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slots, of which the 4th slot here also supports SATA M.2 drives. All of these slots come with the Q-Latch feature, which facilitates the toolless installation of your M.2 SSDs. For audio, ASUS has included a higher-end Realtek S1220A audio codec with premium audio capacitors. Wired internet connectivity is courtesy of Intel's i226V chip, which provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, while Wi-Fi support is courtesy of Intel's AX211 Wi-Fi 6E part, which also serves up Bluetooth 5.3 support. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 7 fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are 3 addressable RGB headers and a single 12-volt standard RGB header located right here. Moving over to the rear I/O, the TUF Gaming Z790 PRO-WIFI goes for an integrated I/O shield design in black. The board comes with a DisplayPort 1.4 connector supporting display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, 4 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports, a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. In conclusion, the ASUS TUF Gaming Z790 PRO-WIFI shapes up to be a budget-friendlier Intel Z790 Refresh motherboard offering with a good set of features, where it comes with a decent VRM setup, PCIe 5.0 support for a graphics card, plenty of USB 3.2 connectivity options, a premium audio codec, and so on. I do wish though that ASUS had included Wi-Fi 7 with this board, seeing as competitor Intel Z790 Refresh motherboards from other manufacturers do tend to come with Wi-Fi 7 as standard. It's worth noting too that this board is likely a replacement for the TUF Gaming Z790 Plus Wi-Fi that was launched a year back, which upon closer inspection seems to be nearly identical in terms of its features. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.